Hi Aquarius, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and to a love check-in for the mid-month June. Aquarius, time is fluid, so you could have been going through something like this previously, are going through it, or will go through this in your immediate future. Also, Aquarius. I've just finished the Gemini reading, so. So Aquarius, these are general energy readings, so will and will not, resonate with each and every one of you out there. So just take what works for you, okay, and just leave the rest. So Aquarius, let's begin. What's happening to the Aquarius love life? And what can we expect around this time? Thank you so much to all my subscribers and for all the love that you've shared with me. And if you aren't a subscriber yet, this is a good time. Just hit that subscribe button. Be very nice to have an energy exchange with you. I have the Two of Cups in reverse and the Page of Swords and the Wheel of Fortune. Okay, but this is in your past. The Emperor, the Queen of Cups, Justice, great, the Knight of Cups, and the Sun. Okay, so Aquarius, previous and recent past, you had a little spat with your loved ones, it seems, regarding some kind of a commitment here. Okay, there was some talk about a commitment, or either you did not offer it, or it was not offered to you. Oops, okay, let's take these. Yes, one of you really wanted a fresh new beginning, and you wanted to bring balance to this equation, but something went wrong with this long-term potential or commitment here, which brought a lot of, kind of killed the love a little bit here in the past. It was probably somebody in the mix was up to some kind of mischief. Some quick communication came, all right? There was a little fight which happened. Maybe too many people were in the mix as well, the gossip, which led to both people feeling a lack of love. Somebody created some mischief in the past, which led to this new beginning, which was just so much potential from not happening, even though the one person really wanted this, one person really wanted to bring balance, one person wanted to bring a new, fresh beginning to this. The love kind of died down here. And the Wheel of Fortune, which is your mutual energy, instead of moving ahead, kind of just stopped or went backwards. Yes, this person, there was somebody here in the mix, right? This Emperor came last reading as well, if I remember calling it Who's Meddling. Somebody kind of took a charge of this relationship and stopped this relationship from happening. Or it just went backwards. Yes, both of you really felt that you could have had a lot of wish fulfillment here. This was like the Ten of Cups for the two of you. And yet, somebody put a little damper on this. And the Wheel of Fortune, which should have moved, didn't. You really wanted to move ahead with this. You really wanted to move ahead. There was passion. You felt, you could be victorious in this. You could have wish fulfillment in this relationship. There was so much love here. But the Wheel of Fortune just stopped. Wheel of Fortune stopped. And there was somebody who played some kind of power struggle, power game with... But right now, Aquarius, at least on this side, I see there's the same Emperor, but he's in reverse. I think this person who tried to control the situation from happening is now kind of bending down and is not being that controlling anymore. Whatever pain and sadness there was, which this person created, I think somebody's trying to ward this off, right? It's trying to take a stance and say, hey, no more. I'm not going to be in this sad situation anymore. And I don't accept this very powerful opposition that, you know, this relationship has been facing. The other person's side also, I see the Queen of Cups, which is, you know, somebody who's still very much in love, who still is a very nurturing, kind queen, compassionate person. So this was a very good mix. And this person also wants to, they want to bring this justice to this equation. They want this. They really want this. They want things to be put right. Because in the past, probably, there was no victory here. And because there was no victory here, one person felt compelled maybe to walk away from this relationship. Or is this happening as we speak? See how much passion there is. Okay, there is so much happiness, passion, yet because of this very controlling mind games or some person trying to control this union from happening, one person is feeling it's best that, you know, one person just walks away. Now, the same justice card, Aquarius, is not only on one side, it's also here on your side. Okay, so it's both of you are wanting this justice to happen. Both of you are not feeling happy without each other, and you know, gone totally within to shed light to see what can be done to bring this relationship back to life. So, Spirit, what is this Hermit and the Justice card, Aquarius? You want to drop this burden, Aquarius. You want to drop this heaviness which has been in your relationship, whatever has been keeping you guys apart, because this, you know that this is your wish fulfillment. Heart of hearts, you want this. You've been praying for this. You've really, really been praying for this. And you want this, you know, justice to be brought back into this equation. You feel so defeated. You feel that, you know, 10 swords on your back right now, and things came to an end maybe. But this is really not the end, because there is, you know, life after this. You, even though in the past you may have felt that things may have come to a total stagnation point, and, you know, your person has moved away from you, but heart of hearts, you both want justice. You both want this to happen. But right now, maybe you're not seeing any forward movement, and that's why you're feeling like this. The other person has the Knight of Cups in their position. So are they hoping to bring you, you know, an offer of love again? Or are they expecting it from you? Yes, they feel that they want the truth and nothing but the truth. They want, you know, they want this cup of love to be brought towards them. Genuine, and they're very discerning about that, that if you come back to me with anything which is false, which is only romantic and, you know, sweet nothings and doesn't have depth, I'm going to cut your head off. Sorry, I didn't mean it literally, but yes, the Queen of Swords is like that. Like, she has had it. She's been there, done that, and now she's not going to take any kind of rubbish offer that comes her way. Why is the Queen, why is this person in the Queen of Swords spirit and the Knight of Cups? Right now they're feeling very demoralized, they're feeling, you know, no victory, not happy. They really want this though. They really, really want this. As much as they're trying to act strict and, you know, pretending to walk away, heart of hearts, this Queen of Swords is actually a Queen of Cups. Okay, they want the stable relationship with you. They're wanting you to come and bring them an offer of happiness and love towards them. Because maybe in the past there was no equal give and take, right? There was no justice. Now both of you have the justice in both sides. Both of you are realizing what has happened and why this relationship has come to a standstill. And yes, it's a time, I think, to work towards it. In your mutual energy, I do have the sun. But right now it's in... Oh... Aquarius, you learn fast, don't you? Okay, so they wanted this Knight of Cups to come towards them. And guess what I have again? The Knight of Cups, right? So I think, Aquarius, this second half of June, you are also feeling there is no happiness without them. And they are feeling the same way. And one of you is going to now take a cup of love and offer again to this person to bring whatever has been wronged in the past to put right. So let's have another card. What is this Sun in reverse and the Knight of Cups spirit for Aquarius? Both of you have been feeling very stressed out, holding on to, you know, this tower which fell. It's not fallen yet, right? So both of you have, it's still in reverse. So it hasn't completely blown up as yet, but both of you are really stressed out about it. And I think both of you want to kind of come forward and talk about the sun which is going down and this tower which is going down. And both of you are realizing that both of you have been stressed about it and want to talk about it and kind of come to some kind of a resolution. So let's see how this partner of yours, Aquarius, is feeling about you. How is Aquarius's partner feeling about them? Spirit? I meant too many cards here, so I'll just do it again. But yes, sneak peek that I took, there was the Queen of Swords again. Okay, so how does Aquarius's partner feel regarding Aquarius? Yeah, they want clarity, okay? They are looking for clarity. They don't want to be under any illusions. They want to make a solid choice now. They don't want to be in that wishful fantasy land anymore. They want something concrete to happen. Let's take another card. Aquarius's partner. Yeah, they feel they got tricked, okay? They feel you maybe tricked them or somebody else maybe tricked this relationship from getting coming into fruition. And they have been in a very confused state of mind, and they really want you to bring some clarity to them and not, you know, play mind games with them maybe and trick them and fool them and, you know, expect them to read their mind maybe. They just want it out like the Queen of Swords, like straight shot. And they look at you as the King of Pentacles, okay? The King of Pentacles is the hubby. He's the good king. I love the King of Pentacles. He's the one who's just takes charge of his family, who provides, who loves, who cares, and is a perfect partner. So this is how they look at you. And they don't want you to be in this magician reverse energy anymore. They don't want you to play mind games with them, you know, or trick them. They want total clarity and nothing else. Are you, you know, with me, without me, kind of a equation. That's what they're looking for. So let's see how you are looking at your partner. How is Aquarius looking at their partner? What are they feeling about their partner? How is How is Aquarius's partner? King of Swords. Yes, you want to bring them clarity. You want to speak your truth. King of Swords is a very good king as well, right? All kings are good actually, but they all have their different attributes. So the King of Pentacles is, maybe doesn't show emotion that much, but when he speaks the truth and nothing else. Okay, so you're trying to match up to this Queen of Swords which wanted to come out. So if they want the truth, you are happy to give them the truth and the truth and nothing else. Oh my God, this seems like a court hearing or something. I had justice from both sides. Now I have the King of Swords and the Queen of Swords wanting to talk and talk direct and nothing else. Yes. You have gone within, okay? You have gone within and you have thought about it, and what you want to tell your partner is that, yes, I've done a lot of reflection and I've shed light to all that was wrong, and I'm very clear of what I want. So, one more card. Yes, you are wanting to tell them that, you know, you're leaving all this devilish behavior behind. If there was any toxicity or anything, and you have gone and reflected on that, and you are very clear on what you want now with them. So let's take you're gonna reach out to them with a solid offer this time. Okay, no more cups and wands and whatever. You have a pentacle in your hand, like this looks like a wedding ring, right? So you're gonna take them a very solid offer this time. Let's take a blessing card from the angels and see what the angels want to bless you with. So God, Goddesses, Angel, Spirit Guide, send us a message. Okay. All right, got one. We'll take one more. Yes, this is... Yes. So, Aquarius, what spirit wants to tell you, whatever decision you're making is the correct one, okay? And whether you go in as the King of Swords, whether you go in as the Knight of Cups, whatever you go in as, you are being guided, okay? The angels are helping you on this path. So don't worry about it. Don't think you're alone on this journey of yours. The angels have you on their back. Okay, they will make this transition very, very smooth for you, and whatever decision you make with this person of yours will be the correct one, whatever you decide. Okay, because you are very clear now in what you want. You are the King of Swords now. You have total clarity about what should be done, what shouldn't be done. And this is what you're going to be communicating with your partner second half of June. And take a call. It's your life, right? I can only read the cards and tell you what is possible. Yes, there's a possibility of clear communication after things have been thought about and cleared out. After that, you're on your own. So do leave a comment, give me a like, and subscribe to the channel, and I meet you next week again and see what's going on. Take care, love and light. Thanks for being here.